Welcome to my channel. Till now we have seen the different kinds of compression techniques. Today we are going to see the predictive coding techniques. These are the simpler compression approaches that achieves good compression without significant computational overhead and can be either error-free or lossy. This approach is commonly referred to as a predictive coding and which is based on eliminating the redundancies of closely spaced pixels. These pixels may be spaced, placed in space and or in time. We are extracting and coding only the new information in each pixel. The new information of a pixel is defined as the difference between the actual pixel and the predicted value of the pixel. Okay. So there are two kinds of predictive coding techniques, lossless predictive coding and lossy predictive coding. So we'll see here first the lossless predictive coding technique. The figure shows here the lossless predictive coding technique model. One A is the encoder and B is the decoder. So each containing an identical predictor here, both will have the predictor. Now from the encoder C, the input sequence is a discrete time input signal f of n and are introduced to the encoder as well as to the predictor. The predictor generates the anticipated output value of each sample, and that is based on the specified number of the pass samples. The output of the predictor is then given to the nearest integer. This will then round it to the nearest integer value and which is denoted by f cap of n, and it is used to form a difference or an prediction error. So e of n is a difference or prediction error, can be defined as f of n, that is the input sample sequence, and the prediction error f cap of n. Okay, so this is the nearest value, predictor's output f cap of n. F of n minus f cap of n is nothing but your prediction error e of n. This e of n is then encoded using a variable length code by the symbol encoder to generate the next elements of the compressed data stream. See, now we have from the encoder, your output is some encoded output which is compressed sequence that we are feeding to the decoder. So from the decoder figure, now the compressed sequence is input to the symbol decoder. Okay, so the decoder reconstructs E of n from the received variable length code word and performs the inverse operation of the encoder. Here, f of n is the output of the decoder, and this can be defined as e of n plus f cap of n, where predictor is fed back into the is placed into the feedback loop here. Okay, so this will decompress or reconstruct the original input signal f of n, that is the decompressed sequence. Okay, so we have the equation. Prediction error e of n is equal to f of n minus f cap of n. Then from the decoder, f of n can be given as e of n plus f cap of n. So now there are various local, global and adaptive methods that can be used to generate f cap of n. Okay, and in many cases the prediction is formed as a linear combination of m previous samples. That is, we can define f cap of n is equal to round off summation I runs from 1 to m alpha I f of n minus I, where round is, we are rounding the value to the nearest operation. Alpha I is the coefficient, prediction coefficient, where I runs from 1, 2, 3 up to m. Okay, if the input sequence of the figure is considered to be an image, that is, this input signal f of n is considered to be a sample of images, then the equations 1, 2, 3 are pixels, and the m samples used to predict the value of each pixel come from the current scan line. So the value are from the current sample scan line and can be called as one-dimensional linear predictive coding. If these samples are from the current and previous scan lines, it can be called as two-dimensional linear predictive coding. Or if the samples are from the current image and the previous images in a sequence of images, this is called as three-dimensional linear predictive coding. Thus, we'll see here for one-dimensional linear predictive image coding, equation number 3 can be rewrite as f cap of n, here we have the equation number, f cap of n, where n can be, we are replacing as images having the special coordinates x and y. F cap of x comma y is equal to round off summation I runs from 1 to m alpha I f of x comma y minus I, where each sample is now expressed as a function of the input image's spatial coordinates, that is x and y are nothing but the spatial coordinates of the input image. This equation indicates that the one-dimensional linear prediction is a function of the previous pixels on the current line alone. Okay, this is the lossless predictive coding. Now we'll see the lossy predictive coding technique that will have the only one block that is additional to the lossless predictive coding technique. Okay, so from the lossless predictive coding, what we have is there is an symbol encoder, predictor, these are the blocks. Now in this section we add a quantizer to the lossless predictive coding model and introduce, we have seen earlier, and we examine the trade-off between reconstruction accuracy and compression performance within the context of spatial coordinates. Here this lossless predictive coding shows the quantizer which replaces the nearest integer function of the error-free encoder, and this quantizer is inserted between the symbol encoder and the point at which the prediction error E of n is formed. This quantizer maps the prediction error E of n into a limited range of outputs, and which is denoted as E dot of n, which establishes the amount of compression and distortions that occur. In order to accommodate the insertion of this quantization step, the error-free encoder must be altered so that the predictions generated by the encoder and decoder are equivalent. From this figure A, this shows, and this is accomplished by placing a lossy encoder's predictor within a feedback loop, where its input is denoted by f dot of n, and this f dot of n is generated as a function of past predictions and the corresponding quantized errors. That is, f dot of n is given as e dot of n plus f cap of n. So f dot of n is input to the predictor, and that is given as e dot of n plus f cap of n, where from the lossless predictive coding already we know that what is f cap of n. Okay, where this closed loop configuration prevents errors build ups at the decoder's output. Here we have the compressed sequence. This compressed sequence we are giving as input to the decoder, and where the symbol encoder will again perform the inverse operation of the encoder. From this decoder we can define that the decompressed sequence f dot of n can be defined as e dot of n plus f cap of n. The output of the decoder is given as f dot of n is equal to e dot of n plus f cap of n. So both the output of the encoder and decoder are equivalent. That is, we can accommodate the insertion of the quantization steps and the predictions generated by the encoder and decoder are identical. So this is the lossy predictive coding technique. From the compression, we have seen different kinds of redundancies into the images, coding redundancy, spatial and temporal redundancy. Then we also seen the irrelevant information, then fidelity criteria, what are the others, compression techniques, Huffman coding, arithmetic coding, run length encoding, then LZW compression techniques, and from the predictive coding techniques, today we have seen the lossy predictive coding technique and lossless predictive coding technique. In the next lecture, we will see the color image processing. So today we will conclude here with the lossy predictive coding techniques. Thank you.